Hello everyone, so today I am going to explain module number 2, introduction to the physical layer and services. So in this lecture we go into the subtopic, that is time division multiplexing. Before continue this lecture, we take a review of previous lecture. In lecture number 13 we also introduced, start with the concept of multiplexing. In this lecture, in previous lecture, we discuss about frequency division multiplexing. Its definition, its application, and it's basically mostly suitable for the analog system. So today's lecture, we discuss about time division multiplexing. Let us begin with the TDM. So first, we already defined what is multiplexing. Multiplexing is a technique in which one to many or many to one. So many inputs are combined and sent over a single line, and similarly at the receiver side we demux, means one into many mappings. So that is what is multiplexing. So multiplexing is a technique in which we can send a data over a transmission line. On a single channel line, many data can be sent simultaneously. That is called as a multiplexing. So we can simultaneously transmit a data over a single channel line. That is called as a multiplexing. So there are the two types of multiplexing. First one is a frequency division multiplexing, and second one is a time division multiplexing. Frequency division multiplexing, already explained in lecture number 13. So in this lecture we discuss about time division multiplexing, its types. So what is the time division multiplexing? Sharing of a signal is accomplished by dividing available transmission time on medium among the users. Digital signal is used exclusively. So time division multiplexing come into two basic categories or two basic subclassification: synchronous time division multiplexing, and second one is a statistical, also called as a asynchronous time division multiplexing. So let us discuss one by one. Synchronous time division multiplexing. The original time division multiplexing, the multiplexer accepts the input from the attached device in round-robin fashion, transmit the data in never-ending pattern. So T1 and ISDN telephone lines are the common example of synchronous time division multiplexing. So here figurally we can explain the sample output stream generated by the synchronous time division multiplexing. There are the four users. Here is a multiplexer device. So we can send a data in round robin fashion, first bit, second bit, in sequential manner. Here is the DR multiplexing and mainframe computers. So this figure explains the sample output stream generated by the synchronous time division multiplexing. Then synchronous time division multiplexing, if one of the device generates the data at a faster rate than the another device, then multiplexing must either sample incoming data stream from the device more offer than the it samples the other devices, or buffer faster incoming stream. Buffers means whenever the data rate of generation is faster than the receiver, that time the buffer will be used. If device has nothing to transmit, the multiplexer must still insert piece of data from the that device into multiplex stream. A synchronous time division multiplexing system which samples device twice as fast, so another device. So we can see here the whenever the transmission rate is more than the generation rate is more than the receiver rate, that time the multiplexer use the switch. Multiplexer transmit system only on the input device. This figure will be explained so data, another are in ideal state. So whenever the data is transmitted, there is a D, and data from the one user and another put 0, that means the other user are in an ideal state in a frame. So this is data will be transmitted over a channel by synchronous time division multiplexing, so that the receiver may synchronize with the incoming data. Transmitting multiplexer can insert alternating 1s and 0 on a data stream. So bits data 1 asynchronous DTF data C, B from the users. Synchronous time division multiplexing are mostly popular three types: T1 multiplexing, which is a classical example, ISDN multiplexing, and SONET. SONET stands for Synchronous Optical Network. So T1 multiplexer of a speed 1.54 Mbps. So 1.54 Mbps, a stream continuous series frame, both digital data and voice channels are same. So 24 separate and 64 kbps channels are used in T1 multiplexed data. So this to be speed, remember what is the ideal transmission rate or physical practical rate for T1 multiplexing, which is a type of synchronous time division multiplexing, that is 1.54 mbps, to be remember. Then ISDN multiplexer stream is also continuous frame. Each frame contains various control and synchronous information. So this is explain the ISDN frame. So control channel 1 byte control, then data bits control channel bit 2, same signaling control information will be present. Then SONET is a massive data rate. Then SONET frame structure will be explained here: N frame, section overhead, line overhead, path overhead, and data. So one frame is consist of 810 bytes or equal to 6480 bits. So what are the advantages of synchronous TDM? It is very popular. Line will require as much bandwidth as all bandwidths of the sources. Then we go to the second, that is statistical or asynchronous time division multiplexing. A statistical multiplexer transmit only data from active workstation or via work when we don't have to. So if workstation is not active, no space is wasted on the multiplexing stream. So in synchronous the bandwidth is wasted, but in statistical time division multiplexing there is no loss of the bandwidth because it works only in active station, workstation. A statistical multiplexer accepts the incoming data streams and create a frame containing only data to be transmitted, which is running with the active station, which is to be remembered. So two stations which are for transmit via statistical multiplexer, so it will take a data from only those workstations which are in condition, in active state. Another data will not transmit it. If we compare this figure with the synchronous time division multiplexing with the statistical, if you observe the workstation which are not working, the data also will be transmitted in the form of zeros, means there is a wastage of the bandwidth. So what is the biggest advantage of statistical synchronous time division multiplexing? That is the bandwidth saving. So to identify each piece of the data address, including address plus data, as well as address of the data and length. So sample address and the data are statistical multiplexer output stream. Also contains the length also include in statistical time division multiplexing. If we explain, we can see address plus length plus data. More preciously transmitted frame contains collection of data groups. So flag controls addresses, length, and data. So this is the structure for frame layout information packet transmitted between statistical multiplexer. So in statistical time division multiplexing, statistical multiplexer does not require line over high speed line as a synchronous time division multiplexing, since statistical SDM does not assume all the sources will transmit all the time. Good for the low LAN bandwidth, which is very suitable for the LAN. So much more efficient for the use of the bandwidth. So why statistical time division multiplexing is more efficient, that can be reason, because it only deal with the active workstation, which is to be remembered. So in this lecture we discuss about the time division multiplexing. There are the two types. First one is a synchronous time division multiplexing and second one is a statistical time division multiplexing, which is also called as asynchronous time division multiplexing, which is most popular as compared to the synchronous because it very efficient in the terms of bandwidth. So we can stop here. Thank you very much.